Hi friends, welcome to Naresh AI Technologies. Today our concept is cryptarithmetic. Now, as far as this topic is concerned, you find the questions from cryptarithmetic in some companies like TCS, Infosys, and you find questions from this chapter in a written test called eLitmus. Now, this topic is important to the students, and what is tested in this topic? We are tested the analytical skills. Generally, we find calculations in numbers, but in this topic, we find calculations using letters, and these letters denote digits from 0 to 9. So, we need to find out which letter represents which digit. Now, let's start this topic by taking small example. Now, the question is xyz plus xzy is equal to yzx. If each letter represents a different digit, then what is the value of x plus y plus z? If suppose this question is given, how to answer this? Now, each letter represents a different digit. Now, here we have three different letters, X, Y and Z. So, each of these letter represents one digit, any digit from 0 to 9. So, we need to place here so that this calculation satisfies. Now, how to start solving this problem? Now, if you clearly see, this is addition. Generally, whenever we start adding, we start adding from units place. So, the first step is I add the digits in the units place. Now, here in the units place, I have letters Z and Y. So, Z plus Y equal to X. Z plus Y equal to X. Now, when I add Z and Y, is this the only answer possible, or can we have any other answer? Let's take a small example. If you look here, 132 plus 243. If I have to add these two numbers, 2 plus 3 is 5. Similar to Z plus Y equal to X. Or suppose I have a calculation. 258 plus 127. When I add these two numbers, 8 plus 7 is 15. But when I write here, I write only 5 and I take 1 as a carry. So, 8 plus 7, it is 5 here. But actually, 8 plus 7 is 15, which is 10 plus 5. So, what is the other value possible here? Z plus Y can also be equal to 10 plus X. Now, in these two, which one is correct? We do not know. Because all here are variables. Z plus Y can be X, like the example I took, 2 plus 3 is 5. Or Z plus Y can be 10 plus X, like 8 plus 7 is 15. But we don't write 15 there, we write only 5 and take 1 as a carry. So, 8 plus 7 will be 10 plus 5, 15. So, like Z plus Y is 10 plus X. Now, let us assume the first one is correct. When I say first one is correct, there is no carry from this units place to the tens place. When there is no carry from units place to the tens place, generally we start adding the tens place now. Now, let's add the tens place assuming that Z plus Y equal to X and there is no carry. Now, Y plus Z is Z. Now, when is it possible? It is only possible when Y is 0. But, if I write Y is 0 here, here also I need to write 0, here also I need to write 0. If I write Y 0 here, X plus X is 0. It is only possible when X is 0. X is 0, Y is 0, definitely Z also should be 0. So, there is no problem at all. But here in the question, it is clearly mentioned that X, Y, and Z each represent a different digit. So definitely Y cannot be 0. Now, is there any other digit other than 0? When we add to Z, we get Z here. Definitely there is no digit. But there is a number, and that number is 10. But as we know that Y is a digit, and I cannot write 10 in the place of Y. But we need to make this Y as 10. How to make it as 10? The only possible way to make this value here as 10 is write the value of Y as 9 and get a carry of 1. It means out of these two, the first one will not help us, or it is incorrect. So definitely the second one we are going to take to solve this problem. That is Z plus Y is 10 plus X, where we get a carry of 1. Now here, Y plus 1 plus Z, I write it Z. So it is only possible when Y plus 1 is 10. If Y plus 1 is 10, so definitely the value of Y should be 9. If I say the value of Y is 9, now the number looks like this. Now this is the number where instead of Y we substituted 9, and definitely there is a carry of 1. Now this value has become 10. 10 plus any digit, that is here it is Z. So 10 plus Z, definitely I write Z, and definitely there should be a carry of 1 here also, because already this value is 10. 10 plus Z, definitely there will be a carry of 1. So 1 plus X should give me 9. That is 1 plus 2X equal to 9. So definitely X value should be equal to 4. So instead of X, I write 4. Now, Z plus 9 is 4. When is it possible that Z plus 9 is 4 and I get a carry of 1? It is only possible when Z is 5. Now you can clearly see the calculation. 495 plus 459 is 954. Now the question asks is, what is the value of X plus Y plus Z? Now the value of X is 4, the value of Y is 9, and the value of Z is 5. So the value of X plus Y plus Z is 4 plus 9 plus 5, which is 18. Now this is how we solve the problems in cryptarithmetic when we have additions. Now this is one small example, a basic example. Now let's take another example where multiplication is involved. Now let's go to the next question. Now let's start with the next question in cryptarithmetic. A, B, C, D, E into 4 is E, D, C, B, A. If each letter represents a different digit, then find the value of A plus B plus C plus D plus E. If suppose the question is given like this, then how to solve this question? A, B, C, D, E into 4 is E, D, C, B, A. So it's a multiplication. Now to tell the answer for this question, we must know certain basic points about multiples of 4. Now just by looking at this question, what is that should come into our mind? The first thing is that A, B, C, D, E multiplied by 4, we get E, D, C, B, A. So clearly I can say that E, D, C, B, A is a number which is a multiple of 4. And multiples of 4 will always be even numbers. If multiples of 4 are always even numbers, definitely the unit digit of this value E, D, C, B, A, that is the value of A, can be either 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. Because
we are multiplying a number with 4 and this is the answer we get. And the unit digit of this value is A, and multiples of 4 will always be even numbers, and even numbers end with 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. So from here I came to know that the value of A can be 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. Now coming from here, now what can be the value of A here? Now A, B, C, D, E, it's a 5 digit number, we can assume maximum it can be a 5 digit number, multiplied by 4 I get a 5 digit number. Now what is the maximum value I can assign to A here? Definitely here the maximum value of A can be 2, because if I take any value greater than 2, if suppose I take 3 here, that is if I write 3 in the place of A, then definitely this number will be a number in 30,000s. I am taking the minimum value greater than 2, that is 3. So 30,000s multiplied by 4, my answer should be in lakhs, that is my answer should be a 6 digit number. But based upon the question given to us, my answer can be maximum only a 5 digit number. So that is the reason I cannot take any value greater than 2. So what are the possible values of A? The possible values of A here are 0, 1 or 2. Now comparing these two, we can clearly say that A cannot be 1, A cannot be 4, A cannot be 6, A cannot be 8. So the possible values of A can be 0 or 2. Now which one is correct? Is it 0 or 2? Now let's check. Can it be 0? If I write 0 in the place of A, then definitely this is the calculation which comes into picture, where I write 0 in the place of A. Immediately which value can we tell? Definitely we can tell what is the value of E, because we know this value 0. 4 into which number or digit gives us 0 here? The digit possible here is 5. So if the value of E is 5 here, definitely here also I have to write 5. 4 5s are 20. Now is it possible here? 4 into 0 should be 0. If I have to write 5 here, definitely there should be a carry of 5. But what is the maximum carry possible when you multiply any digit with 4? The maximum carry that is possible when we multiply any digit with 4 is only 3, because the maximum digit I can write here is only 9. So definitely there cannot be a carry of 5. If there cannot be a carry of 5, definitely the value of E cannot be 5. If the value of E cannot be 5, definitely the value of A also cannot be 0. So A cannot be 0. So the value of A is 2. Now when we get the value of A as 2, my calculation is like this. So definitely this is a number in 20,000s multiplied by 4. Now what are the possible values that we can assign to E here? Now 4 into which digit gives me 2 here? The possible values for E in this place are 3 or 8. 4 3s are 12, 4 8s are 32. So from this place I can say that the possible values of E are 3 or 8. Now from here, what are the possible values of E? Now 4 into 2, the minimum value here for E should be 8. So from here, from this place I can say that the value of E can be 8 or 9 when there is a carry of 1 here. I cannot get a carry of more than 1, because if I get a carry of more than 1, again it becomes a 6 digit number. But according to the question, maximum it should be only a 5 digit number. So the possible values of E here are 4 into 2, 8 when there is no carry, or if there is a carry of 1, it can be 9. So the possible values of E here are 8 or 9. Now comparing these two, we can clearly say that E cannot be 3, E cannot be 9. So definitely the value of E is 8. Now we got two values, one value of A, other value for E. Now let's go for the next letter. Now which value we can tell? If you look carefully here, as we already told that this number is a multiple of 4. Now if this number is a multiple of 4, definitely it should be exactly divisible by 4. Now what is the condition that a number is exactly divisible by 4? If a number is exactly divisible by 4, the number found by the last two digits should be divisible by 4. So what are the possible values we can assign to B here? The possible values we can assign to B here are 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. If I write 1, it is 12, 12 is divisible by 4. If I write 3, it is 32, 32 is divisible by 4, and so on. I cannot write 0, I cannot write 2, I cannot write 4, and so on. Now, from here, I came to know that the possible values of B are 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Now let's check from here, what are the possible values of B? 4 into 2, we have written 8. It means from this place, I should not get any carry. When I say from this place, I should not get any carry, what is the maximum value possible for B here? Now let's see what is the maximum value possible for B here. I should not get any carry. That means the maximum possible value for B here is so, the value of B can be 0, 1 or 2 from this place. I cannot take a value greater than 2, because if I take a value greater than 2, I get a carry. If I get a carry, this number changes and this number changes, this number changes, everything is changed. But already we know, or we came to know that the value of A is 2 and the value of E can be 8. Now comparing these two, what are the possible values of B? I can clearly say it cannot be 3, 5, 7, 9, 0, 2. So the possible values of B is only 1. So here I write 1. Next, if we know this value, immediately we can tell what is this value. Now see the calculation here, 4 8s are 32. It means there is a carry of 3 here. 4 into some digit plus 3 should give me 1. When is it possible? It is possible when the value of D here is 2 or 7. 4 2s are 8, 8 plus 3 11, or 4 7s are 28, 28 plus 3 31. So from here we came to know that the value of D can be 2 or 7. Now from here, what are the possible values of D? Let's check. Now we know that 4 into 1 is 4. So the minimum value of D here can be 4. It can be 4 when there is no carry from here, or it can be 5 when there is a carry of 1. It can be 6 when there is a carry of 2. It can be 7 when there is a carry of 3. Can it be 8? Definitely no. Because the maximum carry that we get when we multiply any digit with 4 is 3. So the possible values of D here are 4 when there is no carry, 5 when there is a carry of 1, 6 when there is a carry of 2, 7 when there is a carry of 3. Now comparing these two, we clearly say that D cannot be 2, 4, 5 or 6. So the value of D is 7. It means from here there is a carry of 3, because 4 into 1 should be 4, but I have written 7 here. So from here there is a carry of 3. Now what is the value of C? 4 into some number should give me the same number, and there should be a carry of 3. When is it possible? It is possible for multiples of 4 when the value is 8 or 9. Now 8, if I write 8 here, 4 into 7, 28 plus 3, 31, there is a carry of 3 here. 4 into, if suppose I write 8,
But already in the question it is mentioned, each letter represents a different digit. So it cannot be 8. Definitely the only possible value here is 9. 4 9s are 36 plus 3 39.
So the value of A is 2, B is 1, C is 9, D is 7 and E is 8. So what is the value of A plus B plus C plus D plus E? So it should be 2 plus 1 plus 9 plus 7 plus 8. Which is 10 plus 2, 12, 19 plus 8, 27. So the answer for our question is 27. Now these two are the basic questions in cryptarithmetic. If you can understand this, definitely you will be able to understand a difficult level of questions. In the next session, we will try to solve some other problems with little bit difficulty. Thank you for watching. For more videos, subscribe to our channel Naresh IT.